So the first time I actually came here was, I want to say late 98, early 99. And I just remember walking in and I felt like how I would feel now, like say when you travel abroad and you go to like some old castle in like London, the London Tower, where there's so much history, you feel like it's, that's how I felt coming to this spot, like where like, I was just like walking around like, oh my God, like this is real place. Like I felt like I was in a special place, which of course it is a special place, especially to us skaters.
For some reason we used to call this place the Santa Monica Courthouse, even though it's West LA. And so I always used to think this area was Santa Monica. Because it's Santa Monica Boulevard, maybe, I don't know, but I used to just write everything on the tapes at Santa Monica Courthouse.
Growing up here and skating with Eric Dressen, he was the one that I used to go to the courthouse with initially, you know, back in the day. You know, he had like a cover on a thrasher doing like a nose bump, tail grab off of that big drop, that big fountain drop. And lights off, four patties to the side, and caressing mask, roll up in a light, wonder keeper in, pass gold, bolting out your sign, one deeper in my ass, don't affect you none, your pop, kidding, rock just song, go strong, no I didn't knock what tongue, cause it's wrong. And I think at the end of Eric's part specifically, in Goldfish, he does like three or four lines at the courthouse. I think if I remember correctly, like his music ends, the song ends, and he's still skating, and he's still kind of like doing all this stuff at the courthouse. And
something that I would say was one of the first things that came out that I had filmed at this courthouse that was impressive, that was a big deal, would be Shiloh's nose blunt on the fountain corner, where he wanted to go inside it and nose blunt the inside of it. And I was like, what? No way. That was unheard of to me. Like, nose blunts were still kind of a new trick still by 92. So just doing them on curbs was sick. And this guy wanted to do them on something that's higher, and it was on the inside ledge. You know, later on, there's still crazy stuff that they did into the fountain. Then there was like Gino Iannucci lines that blew me away too, like switch flip back tail.
Ronnie Krieger, the frontside half cab flip into the fountain here after he ended his line. I couldn't even remember the rest of the line, to be honest with you, but the frontside half cab flip into there. I think he started with switch tail off the ledge right there, off the four stair. In the last 5 years, a lot of my favorite tricks are on the stage, because, you know, now that the ledges are metal, there's a debate with some people, like, is it legit to get real footage on the ledges part? So most people kind of get their footage on the stage. A lot of my favorite tricks are from Nick Tucker. Switch inward heel Manny, tray flip nose manual, backside flip fakie manual, fakie flip manual, all, and then he flipped out all those too, you know, like, man, I'm gonna be driving home later and be like, damn it, I should have said this or that. But like, there's so much that's gone down here. It's all like mashed in my brain. But those are just some of the gems that always come to mind.
Brad Hayes. Brad Hayes to me was the first dude that really like, just like kind of brought the stage to a new level. Of doing like 180 fakie manuals and fakie shove fakie manuals and fakie manual fakie tray. He like just brought it from here to here. And I kind of started, maybe I'll fakie tray up it. And I tried it before and it didn't really work. And then for some reason, I don't know why, but I thought about it differently. And I was like, maybe if I go faster and then pop earlier, it might be able to get up. And then one time I got up and I thought that was it. And then I kept trying and I got into one and fell over and kept doing it, and one just worked out. I think in the footage, I'm literally like, I don't even know what the fuck just happened. It gets blacked out.
Oh yeah, my favorite two tricks was switch heel flip manual. Yeah. And I switched back to 80 nose manual, because I was trying to switch heel flip manual all day and Ray Barbie showed up. And I was like, oh shit, I gotta get busy. And I did the switch heel flip manual. And then like three tries later, I did the switch back to nose manual. Like I said, that ledge ain't sweet and it's still here. So whoever got the bag, you know what I mean? Break it off. cops used to come here and skate. It was a different vibe. And if you can get a clip before the cops came, then it was like a whole different thing. But now it's dope. I like it.
Yeah, it was super sketchy, but I was oblivious. That was so, like, to me, it was like, it was such a beautiful vibe here. It was like, you know, it smelled dirty and like pee in the corner and like all this kind of stuff was still going on. And dudes having baseball bats and like fucking mop handles and like swinging at each other. Like, but it was just all, to me, part of the thing that made this place special. I don't know why.
I mean, listen, it was a homeless encampment there. You know, people would be taking shits on the walls, literally as we're skateboarding, just shit running down the wall. The cops would come, give us all tickets or kick us all out, and meanwhile, there's just this craziness going on there, and they wouldn't even kick any of those guys out. So for some reason, it was illegal for us to skate there, but it wasn't illegal to take a shit on the wall.
It's also a trick finding a place to skate legally in the Southland.
They're not supposed to be skateboarding in here, period.
An L.A. cop scolds and threatens this crew at the courthouse in West L.A.
And I'm going to start putting people in jail for skating over here. I'm getting disgusted with having to tell people the same thing over and over again. This is not a skate park.
Nike came along. They wanted to do their little thing there. And then Alec Beck, who helped get Stoner Plaza built, made them keep, or had them keep the it's skateable.
I think this spot has a huge impact for LA and skateboarding in general, but especially LA, because this has been our spot where you can go to meet up. And kind of like, it was like our Pier 7 and the Love Park and what have you, Pulaski. This is what we had.
This was and is our Love Park, you know what I mean? It's just as important and iconic for us as maybe Love Park was for the Philly guys, you know? Just, I love this place, man. So many childhood memories, and it's cool to be here 20 years later, still enjoying this place, still in love with this place. I could look around and just see memories from my childhood here. You know, worst comes worst. You can't think of any spots to go to and you just want to skate, you just want to have a skate session. Worst comes worst, you can just come here at all the time. So, it's a blessing.